throughout the work. Was that something that appeared or occurred to you as you both being at the start of this of the process?
I think it was quite early on when we spoke about the idea of Philip being in the film, watching himself or watching his life, and commenting on it. That's what really interested me. And we had, I had ideas where you'd turn around and the camera would pan across and you'd go, you did like that. She didn't say that. Or whatever, you know, there's this constant, but very regular presence and commentary.
But that idea is going to come into play at one point, actually, be it city theatre, maybe be in the crowd and comment on the play. You know, thought about all of these different ways of introducing.
So that was cut down quite a bit, but I think you get the idea. The other bit that actually was not so much that, but was a large documentary element about other people that you interviewed and their dance experience. It was really lovely that the documentary layer about talking about dance and the people involved, all those interesting people that you see in that dance competition, there was a lot more of that. And so this idea of drama and documentary having a larger role to play and a larger kind of interplay was there. And that had to be all kind of really trimmed down, and you have to shuttle, like, sort of jogs through something again that Matt's used to having to do, and I was like, oh my god, it's a different kind of thing.
That was the angle of the film, but what we really wanted to do was, because it was such a very simple story, really. It's like, how do you add that to the documentary layer? How do you add the real man and sort of seamlessly kind of blend them together? And it's a lot of thinking, actually. Came after a great amount of contemplation. You think immediately about exactly, you know, he walks on the street and suddenly, you pan off the actor and there's the real guy talking and you sort of came quite late in the piece.
So it was a really strict screenplay. That was the interesting thing. Like, I thought it'd be this, you know, being a choreographer and collaborating with a, you know, kind of a bit freeform. And in fact, what there was this very long pause and back and forth after the play was written, and even during when the play was being written, Matt was there in rehearsals for the play, feeding into the play. And so by the end, interestingly, what I didn't expect was a fairly strict, the final draft was so diamond edged, you know. And then of course, all, you know, that thing, you go and do it, and a whole lot of it doesn't work. So then you go back to it.
If you're in documentary interviews with Rue Philip and he could say anything, he might be terrible, or he was another man.
Sorry, I just want to get clear on that. Were you were making the play at the same time that you were developing the screenplay?
Well, yes. Because we did the master interviews first. And then from that we made the play. But we knew at the same time as we were making the play that we were always going to make this film version. So Matt was in sort of regular connection with the play, but they were not exactly at the same time. They started at the same time, and the play happened quicker because it had to. There was a deadline for it, and the shooting was set much later. So we wrote some of it, or Matt wrote some of it, and then that was changed again once the play was finished.
It was a great process. I mean, I was literally in the rehearsals and we had the script for the play. Then I took that script and that dialogue and turned it into the screenplay. Sort of came up with this sort of hybrid idea of introducing documentary elements.
In the last week of the theatre season, we actually co-opted the actors during the day to rehearse the film script and just absolutely muddled with their head. They had to go at night and do the play, but we were doing all these.
It's amazing.
A whole heap of edits.
How we afford to do the film, make a drama film for the price of a documentary, if you like, which is, you know, drama's a lot more expensive.
That's right.
I mean, the actors were literally rehearsing for the film making the play. So they literally walked off the theatre stage onto the film set and were just ready to go. We could just roll and they knew their lines beautifully.
So it's great.
Elizabeth was there. It's interesting you talk about that the initial idea of the story came out of your interviews with a lot of men, and that idea of for Philip that it's a particularly, it seems to me, a particularly kind of male thing, that dissociation with the body, and it's somehow the loss of his wife, Elizabeth's Melissa is the character, coming in and providing this touch through which sort of a self-confidence can grow. And then finally feed back into that fabulous last sequence of the actual Philip Rose dancing with his kids in the lounge room. How much were you thinking of it as a story of gender?
I didn't think of it that much as a story of gender. I spoke to a lot of men earlier on about their experience with dance, and I certainly spoke to a lot of men who felt very uncomfortable about dancing. And I think there are quite a lot of women who are uncomfortable about dancing. But I did notice that changed a lot depending on people's backgrounds, ethnicity and cultural background. So I interviewed a lot of people from South America or around the Mediterranean country, grew up with folk, kind of Israelis, grew up with folk dancing, and dancing being a part of what people, children did, and old people did, and parents do. And so it was not bonded to the thing you go out and do at a nightclub or a disco when you're in your late teens or mid-teens with someone you want to have some kind of relationship with. So it doesn't get that kind of, so the stakes aren't high in that way. And I think men, and a lot of men feel very uncomfortable about it. Men really want to control their image, their self-image to others, and a lot of dancing has to do with letting go. You really have to let yourself go. And a lot of people feel very uncomfortable about that. So that's fine, but that wasn't so particularly relevant to this. Well, it actually is, you know, when I think about it. Philip does have to, in a way, release himself to do that, to the music and to his exercise. And I think that helps him a great deal to come into contact, re-engage with himself. And yes, there is a crush. I mean, there is a crush that happens that he has, but he knows that. I mean, he's aware of that, and we're aware of that. So I don't play on that relationship too much, but it's an important part of that.
It's interesting how